Okay, let's see if I can push Mini for like 3 meters. Just 3 meters. Okay. Yeah, I still suck a lot with mini push. Yeah, I will probably just waste more time if I keep trying to do it. So just continue from here. Okay, I hope that I can finish from here. Yeah. Yeah, that's just one little thing that I still haven't learned after all of those runs or practice stuff. In regards to 2FM. Let's go. Fortunately, this room shouldn't be as hard. As long as I don't react too late to incoming attacks. This way. Let's go. This way. I wonder how much money we'll be having after this room. If I can afford myself to get a Termaline ring, maybe even. Right now I'm not getting any money pickups. I should probably go out of my way to pick it up. Some of it at least for these guys right here. Get this. This way. Let's go. Didn't really get a lot of money, but it might be enough. Let's see. I don't need any treasure chests. Which makes this challenge right here the most convenient one. Smooth. You know these guys. It should be easier with upper slash, I think. As long as I'm not getting sniped when I'm back on the ground. The synergy between upper slash and aerial dive is so nice. Not as bad as I expected. I find it actually pretty well. Like, super bodied right now. In terms of all of the mayhem. It didn't feel like I was going slow. Okay, now one of the airplanes is probably going to retaliate. Yeah, he tried to at least. I wasn't sure which one of them is going to actually directly retaliate. Okay, let's get rid of this guy and then this guy. Man, I didn't expect it to be a bit rough. And you get magnet. Definitely don't have it just yet. Yeah. Okay, so he is definitely not super armored anymore. After you got successfully. I'm surprised that my counter guard didn't get triggered there. Maybe it has to do with how close I am to him. No, don't attack it. That's the bad part. If you wanna guard quickly and you have Aerial's Reborn, that definitely gets in the way. Okay. Sorry that it took so long. I just keep going for the rest of the world without it. Now just hope that this... Also, what are those weird noises? Like, I'm really not used to having those weird little clicky noises going on there. Maybe it's something that's always been there and I just ignored it. But didn't notice. That felt quick though. You definitely don't need it for the rest of this world. And probably also not... maybe for the next world. It might be helpful. Especially thinking about Boat Fight. Boat Fight can be pretty rough without Chicken Noodle. Alright, three. That was one of my three spell casts that I'm allowed to do. Oof, okay. Probably shouldn't mess around with my RNG. Oh, really? Wait, it actually still came out. I'm actually surprised by that. I wonder if we can one-cycle this. That would be nice. But my damage output might be a bit insufficient for that. Oh, yeah. I knew it. It actually didn't feel too bad. Can't remember what the normal level 1 run does here. To make sure that you get the one cycle like every single time. If it's just pause buffing or if there's something else still involved. It's been like, I don't know, like over half a year since I last watched an actual level 1 run. Like a new level 1 run. As long as I pay attention to what he does, it shouldn't be too hard. Yeah, I knew it. I'm dead. I think there probably is a way to loop him better or more efficiently than what I'm doing right now. Yeah, I think that's probably how the loop is supposed to be done. I think his RV changes in this phase right here. From this phase onward. Man, I should have done this loop in my All Bosses video. Would have saved me so much trouble. Would have been way faster. Instead of that, I actually went for hitting his RV, which made him replenish his HP like this right here. Oh, really? Wow, I actually didn't expect that I could do that. Nice. Could have been way worse. I will definitely take that.